athletes to the line. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our athletes. Minutes preparation and sighting time start.
Dobar dan, dobrodošli, welcome, good morning everyone, all the big boys and girls have arrived now, I'm feeling something in the air, this is going to be an amazing final, already I'm hearing some noise, let me tell you, don't be shy about making some noise and supporting your athletes, I heard some worry things, maybe a couple of Russians have some horns as well, use them during the final, okay, because the music isn't that great, I'll be honest with you. We're working on that. So it's up to you to have a good atmosphere. So, it's 2017, there's new rules, and it's very, very similar to what you're used to. So rather than 20 shots, there's now 24 shots in total if you go all the way to the end without shoot-offs. So we start with two series of five shots, and that's the only difference. Two series of five shots, and each of those series is fired within 250 seconds or 4 minutes and 10 seconds. So it means that the first elimination takes place after the 12th total shot in the competition. That means after the second single shot. The bronze medal is decided after the 22nd shot, and the junior European champion and silver medalists are decided after the 24th and final shot in the competition. Something else for 2017, I'll tell you again. A lot of people thought I was joking when I said, over the next 3 years, I'm going to present athletes in a new way on the finals range, with nicknames. I'm going ahead with this, okay? People thought I was crazy. There's 5 athletes in the world who have official nicknames at the moment. It's going to take 3 years as we go to Tokyo. By the time Tokyo comes, all athletes on the finals range will have nicknames for the world to hear. And to prove that, one of these girls is going to be introduced this morning with her new nickname. I don't know if she knows that yet, but it's going to happen anyway. Really. I'd be surprised, hopefully it doesn't put her off. You remember that you can use your photos and post them on social media and use the hashtag, whatever hashtags you use, just make sure that you include the hashtag ECH2017. So whatever social media you use, just include the hashtag ECH2017. And then if you go onto social media and you click on that hashtag, you can see all of the photos that everyone else is sharing. And I clicked on this hashtag this morning on Instagram, and there's about, I would say there's about 150 photos on there, just of this finals hall and everything around it and all the competitions and everything. I think 100 of them are from Russia, but you can catch up as well. So just include the hashtag ECH2017, and please enjoy yourself. This is my favorite competition of the year. Don't tell the ISSF, please. Again, they might fire me. But I'll come back to this competition every year. I love it. I love you guys. And please make lots of noise, support your athletes, and let's have a really, really good atmosphere today.
Stop, unload. Athletes may remain in position, but turn heads and faces towards spectators.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Hotel Habakkuk for day two of the 2017 European Air Gun Championships. My name is Shaq, and it's an honor to host all finals, including this, the Junior Women's Air Rifle. Let's introduce the eight athletes taking part in this final. On firing point A, representing Sweden, she makes her first final in her first ever international competition, Isabelle Johansson. On firing point B, representing Israel, she placed sixth in last year's ISSF Junior World Cup in Germany, Tal Engler. On firing point C, representing Italy, she debuts in the final eight after competing at the European Championships in the Netherlands 2 years ago, Alessandra Lucchini. Alessandra Luciani. On firing point D, representing Serbia, she makes her second international final after placing seventh last year in June, Sanja Sica Vukasinovic. On firing point E, representing Germany, it's her first final, her first international competition, and she's just 15 years old, Anna Janssen. On firing point F, representing Hungary, 2 years ago at the age of 14, she became the junior European champion in Arnhem, Lelita Gaspar. On firing point G, representing Serbia, another debutant in her first international competition, Tatiana Banjac. And on firing point H, representing France, she competed in Hungary in 2016, but she makes her first final, Jade Bourdet. The jury member in charge of this finals is Mr. Otto Strakušek from Slovenia. And the chief range officer for this final is Mr. Robert Ferenčak from Slovenia. Ladies and gentlemen, don't be shy, make some noise, support your athletes and enjoy the competition.
Take your positions.
Competition with two series of five shots. Two series of five shots, and each of those series will be fired within 4 minutes and 10 seconds. And then we revert to single shots as normal, with the first elimination coming after the 12th shot in the final.
For the first competition series, load. Start.
Thank you.
Stop.
Well, I tell you what, that is an incredible start to the competition. Two athletes hit over 52. The leader is Johansson from Sweden with 52.9. Amazing score. Johansson was the only athlete to hit the 10 ring five times. She shot a 10.8 and a 10.9. Gashbad of Hungary, she also shot 52.5. She shot two 10.7s. She shot two 10.7s, a 10.6 and a 10.9, and her last shot hit the 9 ring. Amazing scores across the board. This will be the second series of five shots.
For the next competition series, load. Start.
Well, what a final we have here. In that series, three athletes hit over 52. Some incredible scores. Let's tell you some of them. Well, Anna Janssen of Germany was the only athlete to hit the 10 ring five times. She shot a 10.7 and a 10.9 as two of her shots. Gashbad shot a 10.9 and a 10.8. Vukasinovic of Serbia, she shot a 10.9 as well. Three 10.9s in that series. Amazing scores. It's fantastic shooting, and it also means that the top of the table changes a little bit. Anna Jansson of Germany moves into second place, and Johansson of Sweden falls into fourth place after hitting the nine ring a couple of times. We now move into single shots in the competition, and this is the 11th shot.
For the next competition shot, load. Start.
Some steady scoring with that shot. Gaspar of Hungary hit the nine ring, but Bordet of France shot a 10.7, and that moves her into second place for the first time in the competition, swapping places with Anna Jansson. Now, the next shot confirms eighth position in the final, and it's a small margin down there. Luciani of Italy needs to overturn a 0.8 to stay in the competition.
For the next competition shot, load.
So, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we have the first elimination of the competition, and taking eighth place in the final, give a warm round of applause for Italy's Alessandra Luciani. Well, that was Alessandra's first ever final, so it's great experience for her and a really good performance. Congratulations. Well, at the top of the leaderboard, Jeanne de Bordet of France takes the lead for the first time now. She hit the 10 ring, while her two nearest competitors, Gaspar and Jansson, both hit the 9 ring. Vukašinović of Serbia shot a 10.7 with that shot, and moves from 5th to 4th position. The next shot is the 13th shot.
For the next competition shot, load. Start.
France is really gaining momentum now. Another 10.8 means she leads the final by 0.7 now. Vukašinović hit a 10.6 following her 10.7. It means that she now moves into one of the medal positions for the first time in the final. The next shot is the 14th shot. It will eliminate the 7th place athlete, and currently that position is joint between Banjac of Serbia and Engler of Israel.
For the next competition shot, load. Start.
Well,
Stop.
That was a brilliant shot from Darlene there at 10.8, and that means that seventh place in the final is for Serbia, Tatjana Banjac. Well, again, this is Tatjana's first ever international competition, first ever, and she made the final in her first attempt and finishes seventh, so that's a really good achievement for her. Congratulations. At the top of the leaderboard, Jacques Bordet scored another 10.8. That's her second in a row, and she leads the final by 1.5 now. Anne Janssen of Germany shot a 10.6, so she swapped places with Vukašinović. 15th shot.
For the next competition shot, load. Start.
Shooting Borde with a 10.6. Her lead is now a 1.8. She's increasing it little by little with each shot, it seems. It's really tight in third. Johansson of Sweden moves back into third position, which is now joint with Anne Janssen of Germany. The next shot decides sixth position in the final. Dahl Engler is 1.6 from safety. That's the difference between her and Vukašinović.
For the next competition shot, load. Start.
So congratulations to her. Some really good shooting all around the board. Bordeaux is now leading the final by 2 points, but there is only 0.4 between second position and fifth position. So it could change with every shot. This is the 17th shot.
For the next competition shot, load. Start.
Decides fifth position in the final. Vukašinović is just 0.1 from safety here.
For the next competition shot, load. Start. There is a tie for the longest ranking finalist to be eliminated. The next command is only for Vukašinović and Gašpar, only. For the shot of shot, low. Start.
Congratulations to Lalitha, what a young talent she is. Remember, when she was just 14 years old, she won gold in this competition. She makes a comeback to the final. She finishes fifth in the most dramatic fashion. Congratulations to her, a very, very bright young talent. Well, Vukašinović saved herself there with an amazing shoot-off shot, the perfect 10.9, so she stays in the final. It is guaranteed her best ever finish, whatever happens. And Borde is still leading the final by a 0.8 now. The next shot is the 19th shot.
For the next competition shot, load. Start.
Well, this is a brilliant comeback from Johansson of Sweden, because for the middle of the competition, she was lingering around fifth or sixth place. She's now in second, just 0.3 behind the leader Borde. She shot a 10.7. Vukašinović shot a 9.9 there compared to her nearest competitor, Janssen of Germany, 10.4. Well, the next shot decides fourth position. And it is the Serbian, Vukašinović, who needs to overturn a 0.9 here.
For the next competition shot, load. Start.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, taking fourth place in the competition, representing Serbia, Sanja Sica Vukašinović. See, I promised I would do it. Well, last year, Sica made her first ever final at the European Championship. She finished in seventh position. She's now finished in fourth position. That's her best ever career finish. So congratulations and very well done. Well, for the first time in a long time, Johansson of Sweden has wrestled back the lead from Border there. She's now the leader of the competition by 0.2. There is only a 0.6 difference between the three remaining athletes. This is the 21st shot.
For the next competition shot, load. Start.
On the range, none of them have ever won a medal, so they're guaranteed their first ever career medals, whatever happens. The next shot decides bronze medal, and Anna Jansson is 0.4 off a silver medal position here.
For the next competition shot, load. Start.
Thank you. congratulations on an amazing final. You guys were unbelievable. Thank you very much for your support. Now listen, we're going to reorganize the range. We're going to have the victory ceremony within 5 minutes. So please stay, support your athletes, watch them as they receive their first medals of their careers. I'm sure they would appreciate it. So please stay where you are. We'll rearrange really quickly and we'll do the victory ceremony. Thank you.
I would ask coaches of the medalist athletes to pick up their equipment, please. Thank you.